Hello students, welcome to course on Introduction to Software Package. So unit 1 is batch processing package. So from that batch processing package, we are going to see the features of batch processing packages. So first we will see that content of the lecture. So first we are going to see objective of the batch processing package and about batch processor and standard features of batch processor, full feature batch processor. So objective of this course is nothing but to say enable the students to familiarize with the features and what and use of application packages. So what are the features comes under these applications? What are the applications? Batch processing, which is nothing but which is Microsoft Word, spreadsheet package, that is Microsoft Excel, presentation package, Microsoft PowerPoint, and antivirus packages. Now we will see that what is batch processing. So batch processing is nothing but it's a software or device. So that allow you to create or edit and print documents. So this batch processor enable you to write text and store it electronically and display it on a screen. Suppose if there is any error, so you can modify it by entering commands and characters from the keyboard, and finally you can print it. Say example of batch processing, that is there is a Microsoft Word. It's a paid version which is introduced by the Microsoft Corporation, and there is a OpenOffice. It's a freeware software which is available on net. So this Microsoft Word is one of the full feature batch processing program. So that is can be used to create a document, edit and format, print, and also save it for future use. So there is some of the standard features of batch processors. So there is many features are available. The first feature is insert text. So insert text is nothing but allow you to insert text anywhere in the document, that is insert text. Delete text. So delete text is nothing but allow you to erase characters, words, lines or pages. So that is delete text. Cut and paste. So cut and paste is nothing but allow you to remove a section of text from one place in a document, that is cut, and insert it somewhere else, that is paste. Cut and paste. So first of all, it's allowing to remove a section of text from anywhere in the document and paste into the anywhere in the document. Next one is copy. So that copy, that is help you to duplicate a section of text. Next one, page size and margin. So page size and margin is nothing but allow you to define various page sizes and margin. So and the batch processor will automatically, that is, read just the text so that it's fit into the size or inside the page size. Search and replace. Search and replace allow you to direct the word processor to search a particular word. So you can also direct the word processor to replace one group of characters with another everywhere in that first group. That means what you have find the character already, so you can change that or replace one group of character with another everywhere that the first group appears. Seventh one, that word trap. So automatically move to the next line when you have filled one line with the text. So and it will replace, sorry, and it will readjust text if you changes the margins. So next one is print. So print command that allow you to send a document to a printer to get hard copy. File management. So file management provide the file management capabilities that allow you to create, delete, move and search for files. Font specifications. So the font specification commands allow you to change the font within a document. So you can specify the bold, italic and underline, etc. So Windows, what is that? So it's allow you to edit two or more document at the same time. Allow you to edit two or more document at the same time. So each document that it appear in a separate window. So this is particularly valuable when working on a large project that consists of several document files. Finally, spell checking. Spell checking is nothing but identify words that don't appear in a standard dictionary. Next one is full feature word processor. So this is one of the advanced features. These all features available in the latest paid version Microsoft Office software. The first one is grammar checking. So grammar checking is to identify sentences, paragraphs and punctuations, and that doesn't appear to meet commonly recognized rules of grammar. Second one, footnotes and cross references. Automate the numbering and placement of footnotes and enable you to easily cross reference other sections of the document. That is footnotes and cross references. Automated list. So automated list is nothing but automatically creates bulleted and numbered lists including multi-level outlines. Graphics. So graphics allow you to embed illustrations, graphs and possibly even videos into the document. Header, footer and page numbering. So this is allow you to specify customized header and footers that the word processor will put at the top and the bottom of every page. So the word processor automatically keep track of page numbers so that the correct numbers appears on each page. Next one is layout. Layout is nothing but allow you to specify different margins within a single document. Macros. Enable user to define and run macros. So a character or word that represent a series of keystrokes. The keystrokes can represent text or commands. So the ability to define the macros allow you to save yourself a lot of time by replacing common combination of keystrokes. Merge. So merge is nothing but allow you to merge text from one file to another file. Tables of contents and indexes. So tables of contents and indexes allow you to automatically create a table of contents and index based on special codes that you insert in the document. Collaboration. So collaboration is nothing but allows user to track changes to the document when more than one person is editing. Some cloud-based web processes also allow multiple users to edit the same document at the same time. Internet features. So internet features is nothing but allows user to embed web links into their documents and format their documents for the web. Translation and speech. Finally, the translation and speech, it's nothing but as artificial intelligence capabilities become more commonplace, some web processes have gained the ability to read text aloud, so to accept voice commands and to translate text from one language to another. So finally, the summary of this lecture one. So there is a batch processing software is used to manipulate text and apply basic formatting to a document. So this batch process is often combined with the other software in an office suite. So along with the Microsoft Excel, Microsoft PowerPoint. So that typical office suite include web processing, spreadsheet, presentation and database software. So these are the references. Thank you.